Hey, I'm Steve Tillman, and today you're riding with us on a 2007 little Sea-Doo. She is the 200 Speedster, and she is equipped with the twin 155 Fortec Rotax engines by Bombardier. And let me tell you, she is in light new shape, and the boat has less than 25 hours on it. And let me tell you, you are getting ready to steal a boat today. Now, when I tell you that this boat shows no signs of corrosion, let me tell you something. Normally I see them and they have got a little hazing on some of the aluminum parts, but let me tell you, these out drives are beautiful. So has this boat ever been to salt water? Yeah, it was previously registered in Florida, and I believe that she probably has had a bath in salt water. Well, let me tell you, whoever had it must have rinsed it off real good and took real care of it. Okay, let me give you 20 cents of how to make your boat live forever. All right, take your hose right here, wind it back so it'll unspin. Okay, take it like this, and then you're coming right here, nothing fancy. You're coming right there, and you're just taking that little jewel, and you're spinning it. See, no effort, effortless. All right, now we're gonna turn the water on and we're gonna flush this bad boy out. The water's hooked up, and see how all that fresh water's flowing out of the back of that thing? Anyway, see how they sound? What you're hearing that impeller in there. So anyway, I'm gonna run for about 3 or 4 minutes to get them all cleaned out. When you do this, and if you're in brackish or salt water, this cleans out the inside of your engine, gets all that corrosion out of there, gets all that salt out of there, and it's fresh. Whoa! She has just a few little light spots in the gel coat right here where somebody's gotten too close to the dock. Probably, if you wanted to deal with that, you could probably sand those, fill them in and buff it. It's got a few little nicks right here in this decal. She's sitting on a galvanized caravan single axle trailer, and the trailer's in real fine shape. The tires are real nice. Hey, let's go for a ride. We just left the downtown boat ramp here next to the River City Brewing Company here in Jacksonville, and it is a beautiful day, but it is a hot one. I'm going to shut both these engines down. She's going to sit there and chirp. I'm going to do this. All right, let's look at this boat. She has absolutely got a beautiful interior on it. I have been all over the seats, the pilot and the co-pilot seat, and I have yet to find a tear in any of them. As you saw in the still shots, she's got storage. This same storage under both sides, this seat and the one that I'm sitting on. And she has ample storage back here in what we call the luggage compartment. But you know, you could put, golly, that's gotta be, what is that, about 4.5 feet, almost 5 feet long. See how deep it is down there? Got your battery switch back over here on the side, and your light pole, your anchor light for your anchors. My favorite spot on any boat is the part where you get in the water, because this is where all the fun is. And as you can see, these boats sit down about, the back of the boat, about 8 inches off the water. She's got a two-step stainless steel retractable. She slides up a ladder in the back. Super nice. All your gauges, port and starboard, tachometer, one speedometer, port and starboard, voltmeter, check engine, oil light, temperature light, got them on both sides, fuel gauge. Got a nice padded storage locker here in front of the pilot seat, then in front of the co-pilot seat, same deal. And this is also is where your engine compartment latch is. And I'm just going to show you back there for a second. Okay, these are the little 155 horsepower non-turboed engines, the twin four-stroke Rotax engine, and Sea-Doo's been building these since late 2004, and knock on wood, I have never had one of these things cough on me, not one time. This boat's got less than 25 hours on it. Actually, it's got way less than 25 on it now, but we're going to drive it a little bit. But she sounds great, has great compression. Okay, Clarion AM/FM Marine AM/FM CD stereo right there, boom, put that up. And then in the belly of the boat, This is where you put your skis and your wakeboard and your ropes and all your good stuff. You could probably put a small cooler down there. Ample long, it goes up between the two seats. Same type storage that you saw up front and you'll see in the still shots. Storage underneath both sides, just like that. Another neat thing about this boat, this is our box that we carry all our safety equipment on from boat to boat. And this box is huge, as you can see. And that is probably about three and a half feet wide up underneath the lip, and then ample, you know, all kind of storage up there for you to put a rope, all your fenders and all that kind of stuff. Storage is not an issue on this 200 Speedster. Okay, these seats go forward, and pilot and co-pilot seat will actually swivel all the way around, so you get that like you want it. And then if you're not height challenged like I am, you can move it back, and that's all the way back right there. Okay, she's rated for seven persons, or 1,365 pounds. Okay, so one apiece in the front, three on the bench, and pilot and co-pilot. See this little flap right here? There's one in front of the pilot seat and one of the co-pilot seat. And you would not think that this wind deflector would make much difference. But when you're going 50 miles an hour and you pull this thing up, it actually takes this wind and shoots it. It is amazing what kind of difference it makes. Chirp, chirp. Let me show you how easy it is. Left engine, port engine. Boom, you're running. Starboard engine, you're running. When that goes off, that means everything's fine, your computer's set, and everything is as it should be. All right, now. If you like your hat, you better hang on to it. Hold on. Riders are going to be interested in speed, so you know they're going to love this 330 horsepower to get them up, and they're going to love that, you know, swinging back and forth. I ain't got me nobody. About 72 or 7300 RPMs. We're sitting here with about a half a tank of fuel and two passengers, and she'll bark right at about 50 miles an hour. So that's scooting pretty good in a little hot rod like this. It's been great being with you on the river. This is a nice boat. It's clean. If you're in Europe, Russia, Spain, the Mediterranean, South America, you ship this boat with confidence that when it gets to you, you're buying a nice boat. Steve Tillman, during normal business hours, call me. 1-866-935-0272. For you folks that have a hard time with that 866 with your international calling, 904-509-4336. 904-509-4336. And be safe on the water, and don't forget to wear your sunscreen. Take care now.